Greetings, beautiful souls. It is your sister at heart. My name is Princess Yanja, and I am here again with another motivational soul healing video. If you are coming for the first time, please do press the subscribe button down below and press the notification bell so that you will be notified every time I upload a new video. If you are a returning subscriber, you know how I feel about you by now. I mean, like, I truly appreciate you. Thank you for being part of the family. So without wasting any more of your time, let's just go straight to today's video. The real devil, the real demon, the low vibration, because everything is energy. And it has a name, it is called fear. There are people who are conquered by fear. They operate from fear. They are afraid of a lot of things. Fear is an emotion, umuzwa. And lomuzwa is clearly accompanied by a force of certain energy. And we can assure ourselves with what we are saying or what I am saying. Because when you are conquered by fear, your state of being is corrupted. You're no longer controlling your own mind. You start thinking of the worst scenarios. You start thinking of the worst that is still yet to happen or still yet to come. And that is the result of fear. Your heart starts pounding faster than normal, meaning it increases your blood pressure. But there is a force of energy that takes over your state of being once you allow fear to conquer you. It makes you feel small. You feel belittled. You feel vulnerable. You feel like anything at this point in time can take place and I'm a prey. And there's nothing I can do about it. I'm living in the mercy of whatever the villain or whatever that is seeking me to consume me. Little do we understand what fear is, us creating this perception in our own heads about a particular person or situations or event or an entity. Everything that we feel when we are going through fear, it's really our own demons. It's the Satan within us, because we are the yin and the yang, the duality of both. So fear has the power to really ruin your life. That is why you need to know your fears so that you can know that you need to face them. And the funny thing about fear is that the only way to conquer, if fear was a disease, we would say the only way to heal fear as a disease is to face fear, is to go through fear. It's like when a child is born, there is this particular flu or fever that the child, in a couple of weeks after birth, that they normally have to go through as a way of sensing or as a way of testing their immune system if it is going to be able to fight. Because this is the world and fighting is part and parcel of what we do here. The only way to conquer fear is to face fear. That's how you know that you have, you know what you're dealing with. You know you have met your demon. Because you might face something that you are so fearful of, but it doesn't mean that the next time you face it, you're still not going to be fearful or you're not going to be scared. But what matters the most is what is it that you choose to do? What actions are you choosing to act on every time you are conquered by fear? Because the actions are the ones that are going to determine whether your demons are controlling you or you control your demons. So there are people who have the fear of death. I think there's a lot of people who have fear of death, especially if these are people who haven't gone through shadow work, they haven't gone through introspection, they haven't done the inner work, they haven't really faced their death, like literally, like they haven't died in a sense of killing the old version of themselves in isolation and coming out as a new person who really have lost almost everything and everyone, but you are still able to go on life and start over if must be. There is that particular point in life, in one's life, where you need to really go through that as a way of saying, you know what, I have detoxed all these indoctrinations. Because as soon as we are born, we are indoctrinated. As soon as you enter into this world, you are being formed into how you're supposed to think, how you're supposed to behave. You are born in a particular race, and already there are stereotypes that are created already in this world that have nothing to do with you. You just entered like a couple of seconds ago, but there's already ideologies based on your gender, on your race. There are these behavior expectations that are expected out of you because of where you were born, the people you were born by, where, how you were born, how you were conceived. Were you in marriage? Were you like, are you a product or a child which is out of wedlock? And also those things are associated with their own beliefs and opinions and judgments and all that energy that goes in that. So by the time you enter into this world, already your identity is stripped out of you. Because now you have to confirm in the norms of the world that you find yourself being brought to. But let me assure you, there comes a point in time if you are a person who is, what is the word? If you are a person who is intentional with why you are here, you will go through a point where you see all that for what it truly is. And somehow your life and your light is going to navigate through a situation where you get to detox all of that out. We talk a lot about a veil. A veil is going to like peel off and you start seeing the world for what it truly is. You start seeing people, even your own parents, even your siblings, even people you call friends, even your own children. And this is where most people, they leave you because now you have shifted. You are no longer in the same vibrational energy you were vibrating on that was allowing you to be able to understand each other. Now you are in a different level. Once you go through shadow work, you enter into a different level and there is no going back. That's the worst part, or the best part for some people. It's like when you watch the movie The Matrix, once you take the pill, there's a blue one and then there's a red one. And there's no going back. You gotta make your choice accordingly. So it goes the same with going through enlightenment, going through initiation, because most of us, there's a certain age that we must reach at, that we must allow our body, mind, and soul to take us into this certain initiation. You can call it whatever you want. Some people call it initiation. Some people call it a psychologist, counseling. You others, they go through their own shadow work through counseling. They have to go through counseling, and that's how they get to see the other shadows of themselves that they've been pulling around or going around with that they were not aware of, that you need another person outside of yourself to point them out for you. Some people, they go through this in the most spiritual way, where they have to go through this process all by themselves. That is why you will find that people you are close with, they're gonna be almost as if they were pushed away by something or someone. It's gonna be as if there was this announcement that was done that, okay, it's time to leave a princess alone right now. When she called for help, don't answer her call. When she called for a shoulder to cry on, ignore her. And this is happening because it's time for you to really discover the lies so that you can enter into the truthful state of your being. And you will not be able to reach to the truth if you are surrounded. So those people are being pushed away. It's painful when it happens, but it's necessary. Because when there's chaos and noise, you will not be able to receive the message. The message needs you in your silent, peaceful state. Unfortunately, there's nothing peaceful about enlightenment. you literally feel like a snake shedding its skin out. It doesn't only end with knowing. There's some work that will present itself to you that will need you to now utilize the new information that you have acquired, and you start being a person who listens more, and you don't only listen to the audios or the things that other people can perceive when they hear. You start listening to even voices that come to you and have a conversation with you. You start becoming best friends with your demons, because now the things you were so scared of, once you start doing them over and over again, they come close to you and they be like, you know, so what were you scared of? You see, good, you were scared for nothing. Because most of the time, ingqondo yethu has this way of exaggerating horrible experiences in our heads. And then when you really push yourself and you push yourself into that thing that you were so scared of, you realize, good, the experience is not as bad as what you have imagined in your head. So ikhandalako has this way of also shaping and painting things in a way that you allow it, you know, to paint them and shape them. So when you are conquered by fear, you will find that you are so scared to take chances. You find that you are so scared to start businesses. You are so scared of being judged. You are so scared with abantu bazothini. You know, there are small things that can unleash that person within you. Even the way you dress. You have been known as this person who doesn't wear pants or who only wear pants. And you coming into a realization years later that you want to explore other parts of yourself. But you're so scared of people who have known you all these years. What are they going to say when they start seeing me wearing a skirt? What are they going to say when they start seeing me wearing pants? Are they going to judge me? They're going to start mistreating me. Maybe they would think I'm possessed. We are so much in our heads more than we should be in our own spirit and soul, and really just operate from inside out. Conquering fear means you're going to walk without shame. As shameful as many people might make you to want to be, or they might wish to see you being, walk with your head held up high. as fearful as you are. And tell yourself that I'm going to face this fear. Almost all people that you look up to, people that you admire, people who live lives that you feel they are the type of lives that you aspire for, they had to face a lot of fears. They had to take a lot of risks, because taking a risk is really facing your fear. It's the highest level of facing your fear. So really, like, if you think about it, being scared really is a waste of time. Being fearful is a waste of time, especially if you want to be fearful and do nothing about it and say, no, I'm not going to do it because I'm scared. Once you are a person who says those words, you have died alive. You have literally created your funeral. You are dead walking. Because life is all about taking chances. Successful life, in whatever the definition or category of success you want, it needs you to always step out of your comfort zone. It needs you to do things you've never done before so that you can receive things you've never had before. You can't keep doing the same thing and expect different results. It's like being mentally unstable, if we are being realistic. But we are mostly mentally unstable when we are not being realistic. So facing the truth and smelling the coffee and really taking the truth for what it is, it's going to help us start doing it the right way. Being scared of death is a waste of time, because we're going to die anyway. Whether you are scared of it or not, eventually you're going to die. So when you choose to be scared of death, you are killing yourself while you are alive about the death that still yet to come for you to really die. So you've died twice in your life. But if you choose to say, you know what, we're going to die anyway, why not enjoy life to the fullest? Now that's a different perspective. So yonke into iqala la. Then you find those people who are so scared of losing things, tangible things, nice things. Hey, we work so hard for these things, my God. We work so hard for these things, the cars, you know, the houses, the lifestyles, the businesses, whatever that you value. We work so hard, especially us as Black people, we have to work 5 times harder because we're starting from nothing, because everything was taken away from us at some point in time. So when you have fear of losing things, you are also wasting your time, because you came in this world without anything. For God's sake, you were butt naked. You didn't even have undies, for crying out loud. And it's so funny how people with greed, I ask myself, you came with nothing. Why are you so greedy? Because you're going to live with nothing. The only difference is that they're going to dress you up this time. But literally, you came with nothing, and we're going to live with nothing. Whatever that you are working so hard for, you are renting it. You are renting it for the particular years you're going to be alive for. And when you die, you're leaving it behind. And people who didn't lift a finger working hard as you did for those things, they're going to just inherit them, or just get them, or buy them from someone with a very cheap, possibly, price that is not worth the heart, blood, and sweat and tears that you might have invested to create those things. So really, whatever that you can get and gain and hold with your hands after working for it, when you lose it, it means you can do it again and maybe even better the second time. So being fearful of losing things also is a waste of your time. And there's people who are conquered by fear, in a sense, Yoguti. Their fear have now became their blockages in their lives. Umuntu ahamba endumbe nayohlola, atshela ukuthi you need to do some cleansing. And then some of the people who have these gifts, they haven't reached the point where they get to really make you understand what they're saying, or to interpret what they are sensing or feeling. If it's a sensation, I don't know how they work, but if it's based on sensation or information or however they get the information, they don't now break it down to you. In a form of cleansing, you need cleansing because you are conquered by fears. And those fears are based on traumatic experiences you might have gone through. So now they are attached like this. And now you operate from this place. Whatever decision you make it based on this, because this is unresolved. There are things that you have limited yourself from doing and becoming that would have been very beneficial for yourself and for your people who are closer to you, your family, your loved ones. But because you operate from this attachment of this trauma and this particular fear, now you have concluded that this thing is horrible. I'm not worthy of it. I'm not even going to touch it. I'm not even going to look there. It's not mine. It has its own people. Not knowing what you are delaying yourself, because maybe your path and your gift and your light requires this to be like this before you can operate and move forth with your gift and with your life. So fear plays a huge role in blocking our lives. You will think you'll need cleansing. You'll think you have diseases. You go to hospitals, they check you and they find nothing. It's fear. Fear of losing. Fear of feeling like you are being behind. Your peers are way in front of you. And this is so painful because it manifests itself into physical diseases in our bodies. Fear of poverty, fear of hunger. Especially people who come from those experiences. They tend to overwork themselves and compromise their health in the process of wanting to make sure that they fight poverty or they run away from it. And you see, ukuthi lomuntu, the way they sacrifice their wealth, their health for wealth, for financial wealth, it can't just be a motivation of wanting a better life. Because if you look at them, they have reached in a situation where they can create a lifestyle or they can maintain a lifestyle that is just enough for them. But they want to keep going and going and going because of the fear. It's that fear that drives them to keep working harder, to keep compromising their health, to keep digging for more, to want to be greedy so that they can keep more for themselves. All these things, they stem from this demon called fear. When you fight your fears and face them, you become the most amazing human being that has ever been. So keep on facing the fears. Judge your life based on how many fears you face each and every year. And see how those fears and facing them will change your life amazingly. I hope that this video did find you in good spirit. Until we meet again, love and light.